And Pavel is the Deputy Minister for Science, Research and Innovation here in the Czech Republic. Pavel, the floor is yours.
Again, thank you very much for the opportunity to discuss with you this quite crucial topics. I was wondering how to conceptualize my opening speech, since I'm here on behalf of the Minister, Helena Langšádlová, and also partly on behalf of myself, and since I will be participating in the first panel, so I have to split the things that I would like to say. And first of all, I would like to appreciate what Martin is doing with the KRECon conference. He already mentioned that this is the maybe third time when we are discussing the research, fourth time, then we are discussing the research assessment topics. And I look to the past and I've seen that in 2012, there was some presentation about the ongoing projects for the reforming of research assessment. There was discussion concerning the implementation or starting of implementation of methodology 2017-4 and so forth. I would say, since I'm part of this conference for the last 5 years, every year, I would say that this conference got a bit of gravity and international impact. So I'm very glad that we have this opportunity to discuss, I would say, crucial things for research. I started with public publications and the open access policy. Then we switched to the researchers and early researcher careers. We were discussing also concept of open science and the way, for example, European Commission sees the concept of open science in the full gravity and extent. So I think that the research assessment is quite logical following on the last, let's say, 4 or 5 years. And it's quite crucial that we have this international impact also with the members of the Opus project and the participants from the Commission. Because from my experience, I think there's usually a big gap, information and communication gap between the, let's say, European policies, sometimes member states policies, and the research institutions and the researchers. And I think that somehow we don't understand each other. Some researchers think something about the buzzwords, but nevertheless, those buzzwords will be influencing the ways the research would be conducted and funded. So it's quite crucial that there is a facilitation, there's a communication, there's an understanding, there's an explanation of the concepts and the policies. And I think KRECon is one of the very few opportunities to discuss this to quite extent. And I'm very glad that throughout those 2 days, we will be discussing not just the overall concept of assessment, we will be discussing the researchers' assessment and the grant application assessment. I think it's quite crucial and I very appreciate that. One of the big topics definitely will be the so-called COARA or ARA agreement on research reform of assessment. And let me say a couple of words on behalf of what I think that is crucial take-home message from this whole conference. And those are twofold. One is that for different research activities, there is a different application of measures of peer review of all sorts of metrics. Sometimes when we are discussing the assessment, we think of assessment, for example, methodology 2017+, which means the assessment of the institution. Or within the institution, we think it's just the researchers. And we are not able sometimes to switch. There's a different levels of assessing, there's a different activities, and every one of those has different demands on how to tackle it. And it's quite crucial. So again, it's quite important that we are discussing assessment of grants, the assessment of people, researchers, teams, and assessment of institution on the national level, on the institutional level, on the individual level. Even though that the scope of this conference is quite large or extent, we still do not tackle all the ways we evaluate internationally in Czech Republic. For example, we evaluate so-called large research infrastructures. There are projects, but they are far beyond basic projects from agencies. It's a special peer review international evaluation. We will not be discussing those. I'm just saying the extent. I mean, that the problem is quite complex. We are evaluating the means how we are participating or how we provide our memberships towards international institutions like CERN, ESA, ESO. Obviously, also those are evaluated internationally by peer review. We will not be discussing those in those 2 days, but nevertheless, it shows you that the extent what can be assessed in research is quite complex. So that's one take-home message. And the second take-home message is the research assessment is part of bigger picture. This is something that we usually forget, that there is no way and there is no point of discussing research assessment if we are not seeing the whole picture with the publishing policies, for example, APCs and so on, and, for example, open data. I mean, those are controversial things, things that are starting being discussed, but it all makes one big picture. If we take assessment all alone, we are not seeing what is going on the national level, and we are definitely not seeing what is going on the European level. So I think this is the second take-home message. It's not about whether in the module one or two, there's a big, tiny problem in the methodology. We have to discuss what is the context and consequences of the way we measure research concerning the ways how we are funding, publishing or reading of electronic information resources and the way how we are storing and producing data and many more. But I will say just those three points. So the second takeaway message is, it's not just about the assessment, it's the overall policy. If one of those doesn't work, the other one won't as well, or not to the extent that we would like to. And the last couple of words is, because I wear different hats, I was at some point when I was transiting from the Ministry of Education to Charles University, I was a part of the so-called core group, which is a part of 20 people across the Europe, from research institutions, from providers, from agencies. And our responsibility was to draft the agreement on research assessment reform. And I just wanted to say at the very beginning, what were our expectations and what are my personal take-home messages from this process, because this core group was responsible for the text of the agreement, and we will be discussing the coalition and how it works and what does it mean to be part of it. I think there were basically five common understanding what should we do and what is important. One was that we were drafting the agreement, we thought that the way how you assess research definitely influence how the research is conducted. I think it's quite basic. So we have to take very good care about that. So that was the easy one. The second prerequisition or expectation was that public policies and the manners how research is conducted should be, how is assessed and supported also financially, should be done by public bodies, governments, in cooperation with research institutions. This should not be done by ranking agencies and publishers. That's a much more tricky one. Again, public policies concerning research, assessment, and funding and legislative framework should be done with cooperation of public bodies and the research institutions and researchers, not by ranking agencies and publishers. I'm just saying that because of what's one of the main topics of the coalition. The third one was that we wanted to accelerate process and implementation of something that we thought is common value, common understanding. If you look at the COARA, if you look at the commitments, I don't think there's anything you can disagree in the ideal way. Obviously, you can disagree with the way how it is implemented on different level, different scale. But nevertheless, the values inside, I would say it's quite common, or we thought they are. Maybe in the discussion, I will hear from you that it is not that way, and I think it's definitely fruitful discussion. The fourth one is to make it participative bottom-up. Many of the declarations, and some of those were mentioned, was top-down. They were politically oriented, and it means that the research terrain or the landscape wouldn't accept that. So we wanted to make it participative bottom-up, and also the COARA coalition and the whole structure of the governance is done by researchers. So we hope that this way it would be much more proficient, sustainable and feasible. And the fifth one was that if there should be any progress in the matter of research assessment, there definitely should be some accountability, reputation, incentive for all those who are participating. And obviously there should be some track record, so public information about the progress. And all of those that are part of the coalition have some kind of responsibility or accountability to discuss the way that they are promoting the principles and the commitments that they were. So this is something maybe for the start of the debate. What was the initial ideas of the 20 people that somehow wanted to write this agreement? And my personal take-home message from those, and I will be very, very short, I'm not sure if I'm overlapping in time, was that there is a obviously conflict between ideals and practical implementation. Because if it should work, it should be a revolution. And we know from the day-to-day operational politics that there is no room for revolution but evolution. And we need to tackle and we need to see whether how we are doing. We can say that what is going on in this quora is quite European mainstream opinion, at least based on the participating institutions and people. If somebody would ask me, in Czechia, I would use the word Czechia, not Czech Republic from now on. In Czechia, are you in line with KRECon? I wouldn't say yes or no. I would say, what do you mean? Do you mean like the national methodology 2017? Probably yes. Do you mean the institutional evaluation inside universities or institution? Yeah. Maybe in some, maybe not in some other. So I think the topic is much more complex than to say yes or no, are you in line or not. It depends on the level, on the granularity of the assessment, and on the activity that is being assessed. The fourth take-home message is, in the end, it's much more important what you do assessing the researchers, not the institutions, because you have to be able to say that what you're doing has some merit and impact on their career path. Because that's the only way how you incentivize that they are doing, or maybe the outputs of their research is being done. So maybe the focus on the research careers assessment of that could be something to discuss, and not just the evaluation or assessment of institutions themselves. And the fifth one, and I think it's important in this group of people that is gathered here, that this is not just about technicality. It has also political implications. All those words and the buzzwords that we hear, like impact of research, communication of research, effective use of data, knowledge valorization, all of those terms will affect the way how the public spending will be justified, definitely on the European level, but at some point also on the national level. So I think it's also, and I'm coming back to my first point, it's necessary to communicate, to explain what does it mean, because definitely if you look at the European level, if you look at the debates that is going on, for example, concerning the new Framework 10, New Horizon, you can definitely see that this concept of socioeconomic impacts, altmetrics, open data management plans, knowledge valorization, definitely those, let's say, buzzwords would be shaping the way how the research is done and how it's funded. So I think it's important. And again, thank you very much, Martin, and people from the organizing team, that we have this opportunity to discuss it. I hope it will be controversial because those topics are very complex and very hard to tackle. Nevertheless, it's quite crucial and important. Thank you.